Welcome back to Taco Bowler Gaming. My name is Taco Bowler, and today we are playing Millennia once again. So hopefully there'll be a little less explaining that has to happen in this episode, and we'll just go ahead and move. We gained another forest tile in our mainland. That is excellent. I do definitely enjoy that. I'm kind of thinking that our army is time to go back home. So I'm going to just tell the army, you actually need to get to here, and it's going to take 7 turns and it'll do its thing. But I think that it's time to get back home for you. We have 4 improvement points. I need to get that going up. I'm not overly sure how to do that, actually. So scouting is done. We're going to go ahead and, like I said, just do defenses here. It would take 7 turns to get the Age of Bronze. We're not going to worry about that quite yet. The defenses are really, really important. It lets you have additional defenders in your towns and lets you build the archer units, which defeat armies. Right? That we don't have siege units yet, but the archer units are what you would use to defeat armies. So that's really important here. And we got a extra scout for going into this age, which is what we want. So again, I set that up. We just continue the move. It's fine there. And now you. I'm going to bet that this is exactly what it is. Not going anywhere. So we'll kind of move in. This area here, this is not an enemy nation. This is going to be a minor nation for the barbarians, which we can fight, or we can actually defeat it another way. We'll worry about that. And I'll probably show that, trying to get them into our side with an envoy. So this is a barbarian camp. This is the barbarian. That's what's going to actually threaten me. I think I want to make sure we're defended. I don't think he can get to me back here. Continue to move. And now with you, we'll just kind of move around here. We have a peaceful camp there. Yeah, see, so he tried, but he didn't have enough movement to get here. And so now I can kind of get around him and be away. But here's another barbarian. He will definitely attack me here. I am in trouble with this scout, but we'll see. See what happens with it. It is what it is. China has 51 on that. So part of why China is going to have a bigger power than me right now is because it's basically the same thing. We'll spy on another scout cavalry here. But I guess if I went over here... Oh, actually, our power is more than China. Take a look at that. So one thing to note, we do have a 4th person in our city now. And they're working the grasslands. I don't really want that. But our food is at 138. I think for now, we're not going to do that. I want the production. So go work in the forest. And our city can grow a little bit less for a little bit. It's going to be fine. So yeah, he did attack, but the scout survived, which is good. There is our archer, we are complete there, so that's good. We're going to move the archer over here to Lodi. The main city is kind of a little bit more protected. If a barbarian walks in here and it's completely undefended, this city is razed, our borders shrink, it's really bad. This would get sieged, there's some units that would rise up, city militia times 4. I don't think a barbarian can overrun this. It can overrun Lodi. It only has 2 militia. So that's kind of what my thinking is here. We also have 25, so we can get our improvement points, which is good. This makes the government ready for peaceful revolution, which I think is probably how we get out of tribal. We'll see. I'm gonna go ahead and get the thing here too. So we're just gonna have him guard, and we'll do his best here. So I'm not gonna sit through this. Just go to the end. That went about how I expected it to go, but we are able to escape and get up a little bit, get away from that guy. I'm thinking that the volume here is a little bit high for the game. I'm definitely going to have to worry about balancing as we move along. So now this guy might attack here. If he does, I think I'm okay. If he attacks there. Not overly concerned about it. This guy I'm sort of concerned, but we're in a forest. We should be okay there. There's a lot of minor nations. Alright, so the defenses, we saw that that was done. So now I can do nothing but move on to the Age of Bronze, which is fine. We'll note up here that Egypt is already there. They're 51% of the way through. China is 36%. Persia is 27%. We are 0% of the way through, but that to me is fine. The next one, there's options. So in that one, I want to have that. Here also, we can use 10 warfare. We have 13 to promote this unit, which is now a veteran unit. You can see that one thing down here. We can make it a leader, which would change it from cavalry. That's the one thing I don't like about the system. I wish it was a cavalry leader and a line infantry leader and a ranged leader. But no, it's just a leader, and it would stay whatever technology level it was as well. But it would change into a leader. So when we are kind of settling in and creating conflict armies, that would be something to think about there. All right, so he moved up, but he did not attack. So there you go. Ooh, nice. Another peaceful camp. Go get this one. A temple. A massive temple pyramid lays before you. Its contents and purpose are unknown. Grab that 20 exploration. Give me another scout, which has to spawn in one of our cities or towns, but we're going to go ahead and spawn it in Lodi so we can be a little bit further when we go ahead and spawn. Let's go ahead and just continue our move. You're just going to stay. And the region is idle. That tells me that I need to produce something in the region. So the lookout is actually pretty nice. It gives you border vision, which I don't think it expands the borders, but it kind of gives you vision a little bit out there. But importantly, it gives you some defense, the defensive lookout unit. So it's even more defense in that area. The food stockpile. It's just food storage level 1. I don't think it actually creates food, but it's still a pretty good thing. I tend to think it's a good thing to do, and I'm probably going to do it. This extends our borders in the city. Which would also be pretty nice right now, but it's 5 turns. These are 4. I think I'm going to go ahead and do a food stockpile next. And I have 9 points. I'm going to go ahead and spend some of them on a hunting camp here. We can create a farm and a clay pit. I probably should have, I should have saved up for the farm here. So that's important to remember for me a little bit later on. I have way too many armies in my mind, but eventually you kind of have to. There's so many scouting units. All right, where's the... Oh, yeah, okay. Oh, my... The barbarians are coming down. They want a piece of me. We'll get in the forest. We're going to move around here. I'm just going to stay there. You go over here. Strange designs. The machines and tools used in this village are unlike any other. They serve purposes and are designed with completely unique ideas. I'm going to go ahead and use the improvement points, actually. I think that's great. So that gives me 10. So next turn, I'll be able to build the farm up here on this wheat, which is what I should have done earlier. Instead of this area, I should have either put it here to get more bones, or here, which gives me far more food. But that's the kind of thing that I would be learning for next time. Another undiscovered thing up here. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Excellent indeed. So China just took that thing out here. So who's moving us forward? Egypt. Into the Age of Bronze. So some new national spirits unlocked. We'll talk about those quickly here. Vassals integrate 2 times faster, but I don't have a vassal. I'm not going to integrate them if I did. Barbarian warlords may now appear, so we have more powerful barbarians that could wind up there. Innovation events and chaos events may appear, and I don't understand those perfectly well, but I know them and I see them. Then trade and diplomatic envoys are available, and that's the big one for us. Is that the envoys become available. So let's go ahead and... yes, they have entered the age... Yeah, okay, thank you. I didn't mean to play the thing again. Okay, escape works to stop that. So we can raise a tribal army. We can spawn a settler. That would create a new vassal for me. And I don't know if I want to do that or not, but maybe. Maybe. What was I actually looking for was the power. I have to actually enter the Age of Bronze before that's available. Okay. So I'm not seeing it. And there's a reason. I'm gonna come up here, see if I can't go around that way. There's a bunch of barbarians right here. I'm not sure they can actually get to me over here because of the hills. And if they can, oh well. Another peaceful settlement right there. But up here, we have another undiscovered landmark. Let's go ahead and discover it. Ah, the pyramids. The Grand Canyon. So not the pyramids. And that takes up my turn. What is this? Oh, olives for wealth. Okay. Something else to think about is with the clay pit, which I do want to get at some point, is that we can kind of create supply chains as we go. That was excellent. The wheat, really, really good stuff. It gives you 3... food, and there were 2 of them on that thing, so that gave me 6 food. We're all the way back up to 200%. That's going to be excellent. So yeah, we'll try and get that on the forest next turn. I don't think there's anything else that I can do. Now we are in the Age of Bronze. Now we can have a national spirit. So let's go over here. I don't see any new ones. So the Olympians one, that is interesting. I don't think I ever actually used this. I genuinely don't know that I've actually ever actually used it. But you can have this stuff. A lot of the national spirits, you can unlock buildings and things, and this gives you stuff. 110% defense on line units. Interesting. We can generate 300 wealth just from opening negotiations with 2 nations. That's neat. The most powerful one, I think, was warriors. Because you spawn these Spartan units. The Spartan units are really, really powerful units, especially in this kind of early warfare where you're not going after taking regions, taking cities. You're just fighting armies and maybe trying to sack the enemy little cities. Okay, so they have built a settling over here. So, like, this kind of point, I'm not going after this. If I were to fight a war with the Chinese, this would not be my target. I would be going after cities like Lodi here and trying to overrun them because they can give me quick wealth. And the combat that I would be going for is all that. The Spartans are really good for that. You can get this here where they don't cost you anything. The fortifications, so if they do go after your main cities, those are big. I think this is a really powerful one if you're going to combat. Ancient Seafarers is just not that bad either if you're in a kind of navy map or if you're in a spot where you need to be there. But I thought that the Mound Builders was the best one. You get the construction for the farm goes down. The capital just gets an automatic region level. Again, the food needed per population gets cut in half. And then you get the sanitation, which is a new need in the Second Age as you go. I think this is really, really big. And so this is the one I tend to go for. But really, warriors, the God King Dynasty could be good if you are near stone. If you're near a bunch of mountains and stuff, that can be really good. But really, you're looking for limestone and like stone towers and things. So you need some of that before you can get that. But expansion into hills, nice. But yeah, the warriors, if you're going to be fighting, the seafarers are nice if you are at all on the sea or if you're in an island map or something like that. That's all really good. The wild hunters, they said, was not too bad either. Ooh. Actually. And the problem is that they require exploration points to upgrade. I don't know that I have that, but this... We have bone. We have bone twice in our main capital here, and we could get improvement points from it. That's not a terrible concept, but I can't generate exploration that well. What does the Mound Tradition do again? Generate sanitation per burial mound. And the burial mound generates two culture. I like that farm improvement, but you know what? Let's give it a go. Wild hunters. Yeah. The bow hunter is a ranged unit that's improved archery. I'm gonna guess improved archery. I don't know if this is going to be a good idea or not, but that's what I'm going to do because we have that level here. So for the Wild Hunters, we already have 25 exploration points. So that's good. So we can maybe get that later. All right. Enough dilly-daddling. So much barbarians here. I don't like this. Move into the hills and hope that they don't want to go after me. You notice the unit is a little bit stronger than the 15 they 14 they were earlier. So that's good. We found a small camp of nomads. They explained to their leader is very wise and willing to share knowledge with us. We can get 20 government or 20 warfare. Let's just do government for now, and we can run over here, and we can get the peaceful revolution. Reform the current government into a new one requires the reformed ideal from your current government to be used. I just don't know where to use it. Expansion. Oh, yeah, the settler. I could have used the settler there. So here is our innovation up here. Changes per turn 10. When it fills up, you get an innovation event. This is the chaos. When that fills up, you get a chaos event. It's not too much of a thing. I'm trying to find where I can change that government. Maybe it's in here. It's definitely not. Who knows? If you know where I can find that, where I can change that, be my guest, but I don't know where that is yet. Maybe that, again, that's a thing for four, you know, age four or something like that. Okay, so you're kind of blocking my way here, so I'm gonna not go that way. Yikes. Okay, these are already used. So the research here, we are in the Age of Bronze. We can kind of do these things. So, I think getting the temple is really in mind here. I don't think we have grapes, rice, wine in our nation currently. We know where one is, but not currently. And so you can see here that some of these here, like, converts wool, cotton, and flax to cloth. So if I had wool, cotton, and flax, I could get this immediately and produce cloth and get more wealth, which lets me keep larger armies, etc. Olives, which we saw in olives in that one spot, goes to cooking oil, which can do that. And that produces a lot of food, as well as some wealth. So that's nice stuff. We can spend wealth through rush building and unit production in this one. Here, again, if we had done a clay, which we could still do, and I might do here, this gives us a kiln, which lets us turn the clay, which is one production and one improvement point, into a brick, which gives two production, two improvement points. Really, really nice improvement there. It's a great one to have. Converts wheat to flour. We have wheat. And this gives us a saw pit, which gives us the engineering XP. That's not what we needed anymore, but the engineering XP is nice. I'm kind of thinking this is going to be the one we need because it helps us there. Here's the warrior one, which is nice. Both these powers are really nice. Reinforcements, it restores an army's health and morale at the cost of some combat experience. Really, really nice. The spear unit upgrades our line units. And then this is upgrading our scout cavalry to a chariot, or it adds a cavalry unit, if you will, if I'm using that in battle. This won't be a scout, but it's good for that. Here's the officials, the envoys. That's really, really nice. Also gives us a cultural power of claiming a region next to our natural territory next to it. We just kind of absorb it with some culture power. When we are done with that, we can bribe an army or a barbarian to disband that, using some of our wealth, just disband some of the barbarians. Not a bad shout. The envoys are really important, but we're not going to get that yet, partially because of seven turns and this is five. Here's a pioneer. Those are also really good. They set up outposts, which kind of extends your city a little bit. the stone cutter and quarry. So this is again, if we're in the hill area, this is where we'd want to be. And then the shipbuilding is what lets you have docks, also lets you load to transport, let you move your ground armies into the water, which is nice stuff. But we won't get that yet. The other thing to note again, the Age of Heroes. So the Age of Iron is what you would normally go into if you do nothing else. The Age of Heroes, if you have discovered three landmarks, you can lock yourselves into the Age of Heroes. And I think that locks period to where when you do the three technologies, if you move the nation, if the world forward, you are automatically here. And then the Age of Blood, if you slain from six other nations, and that includes the minor nations that are already vassalized by someone else, then you are locked into the Age of Blood, where everyone declares war on everybody else for the entire age. Which is not ideal, but it is a thing. All right, so we have one turn left. We will get the food. Okay, how did this go? We sort of kind of held our own a little bit. Now just get away. We're gonna move on up here. Now this scares me a little bit more. We're still alive. That's what really matters. We have an undiscovered landmark right there. That's what we want. Hopefully he does not die in that amount of time. But I'm kind of thinking that these three need to start getting together, or at least a couple get together to defend themselves from some of the barbarians. We'll see. Here is an army. It's not an ideal army, but at the moment, I don't have the ability to get a fourth unit. By the way, I think that in here. No, I want community. I think in here is where you would get that fourth unit ability. Maybe it was in the power, the military power. I don't know, but there was a way to get a fourth unit in the demo land, the demo turns. But not something that we are doing yet. We're just gonna guard here. And our region is idle. So, let's take a look here. We have a meeting hall, it gives us some diplomacy. An encampment, which gives us warfare. XP. The work camp, which gives us production and engineering XP. Not a bad shout. And then this, which expands our nation. We also can build our war bands, which is our line infantry, our archers, which are the ranged, and a city guard. Later, we can upgrade those. So, again, not a bad shout. I'm thinking the work camp or just building going ahead and building the walls or the dolmen. I think let's go ahead and just build the palisade walls at this point. Just get that started. Get that going. And we will end our turn. We need to find where those elephants were. I thought they'd spawn like in our area, but they didn't. So the other thing we can do here is we can build a dwelling. The dwelling, we will eventually need a housing need. And so we'll have to spend some of our tiles to fulfill that housing need. But for now, that is not something that we are going to be concerning ourselves with. And like, I'd build the housing here because I can't build anything that's worth that much more. The hunting camp's worth three food. But here, I can build a clay pit, which gives me that production, the improvement points. That's kind of what I want. And the wheat here is worth that as well. My city's not growing out very far, partially because it's stuck on the sea there, which isn't ideal. All right, so first off, let's discover this landmark. And we have discovered Mount Everest. Excellent. So here's another thing that I'm going to do here. Regrouping. We can pay 5 exploration. I am not going to pay 5 exploration for it. Oh, we haven't revealed the elephant yet. We need to do that. But we could pay 5 exploration. That just moves it to the nearest friendly settlement, which is our main town right now. So it's a way to quickly get the scout out of danger. But we're not going to worry about that yet. Okay, so that's what I was thinking is the case here. So we're going to move back right here. And we are going to move these two together, I think. And just kind of hang out. And we're going to move you up here and get them together so that we can scout a little bit more favorably. All right, so we can use our culture power too. So the absorb outposts lets you integrate, you know, using that. Create town would be excellent, except that you have to have a certain level, and this region's just not at a level that can support another town at the moment, which kind of stinks. We could raise an army, which is not a bad call. We have the wealth to do that. Or we can use Eureka to immediately gain some knowledge. And again, it would be less effective next time we would use it in this age. But I think that that's a good thing to do here. And that gives us the research completed for community. And let's just build a mill, which is nice. And I'm going to go immediately over to Belief next. And then I guess the Crisis Age is when you're locked in. We could do Age of Heroes or Age of Iron. I kind of like the Age of Heroes when I got to that one time. Here is the elephants. That's what we want. That's what we need. So we need to get over there because the elephant lets me build the ivory on the honey camp, and that gives me 1 exploration HP each turn, which will let me begin to build that out. That's what we want. Ooh, look at this. Maybe we need to actually fight Erdine here. Or use an envoy. So I think I'm going to call this one here for this episode. I hope you have enjoyed. And if you did, please do like, please do comment, please do subscribe. Come back next week. We will continue with some Millennia, and Hearts of Iron will also return, and we will be exploring a little bit more into the game, and I'll hopefully be moving a little faster as we get less to explain. But I've been Taco Bella Gaming, and I'll see you next time.